Greetings. This is a Solar Watch for November 27, 2011. A coronal mass ejection has just clipped the Earth's magnetic field, registering a K4 on the KP index. We'll now look at the latest solar wind telemetry from ACE, and we have seen a major change on their service over the last 3 hours, which saw solar wind speeds move from 350 to 550 kilometres a second quite rapidly. We also see the same increase in solar wind temperature, and they're at very high levels at this present time. Solar wind density is still fluctuating quite violently, and also the interplanetary magnetic field is showing a strong southerly push or a negative polarity. And that's an indication that we have caught the leading edge of this coronal mass ejection on the Earth's magnetic field. We're now looking at Cactus, which is a digital representation of coronal mass ejections as released from the solar corona. Now, there have been three halo CMEs registered on this service since my last video, and two of them we're looking at right now. And these are pretty much a simultaneous eruption, and we do see a northern and southern hemisphere eruption take place. Now, this is a fairly weak coronal mass ejection, but it is headed Earth's way, and a fairly slow-moving one as well. And that would imply that December 1st, we may see a slight elevation in solar wind speeds, but nothing too drastic from this ejection. We're now looking at the third and final halo coronal mass ejection as released from the solar corona using a split screen of Cactus and a stereo ahead core 2. And on these images we see a much more powerful coronal mass ejection. Now it does appear that components will hit the Earth's magnetic field in around December the 1st, which will mean that this coronal mass ejection should catch up to the other two which were released a day prior. So we should see some sort of impact on the Earth's magnetic field on the 1st of December, which could have a geomagnetic storm effect the following day. We're now looking at the auroral ovals, and we see a little bit of activity on this service due to the arrival of the coronal mass ejection. Now, the Earth's magnetic field was buffeted quite severely, but it did bounce back quite rapidly. But we may be seeing strong auroras over the next 24 hours for those areas at high latitudes. We're now looking at the GOES Xray flux monitor, and over the last 24 hours, a slight increase in flare activity have been noted, with 7 C-class events being recorded. But the main area of focus is this strong elevation in Xray background. And this is due to the emergence of a new active region about to turn the southeastern limb, which does have a very strong magnetic field associated. There are currently 8 numbered active regions on the solar disk at this present time, with 3 regions producing C-class flares over the last 24 hours, and they are active regions 11358 at disk centre, 11361 and 11362, all producing moderate C-class flares. But the main area focus is a new region that's yet to turn the southeastern limb, and that's active region that's yet to be numbered. Now, this region is already producing C-class flares, so this could be the harbinger of some significant flare activities for the coming week, and definitely worth keeping a close eye on. We're now looking at an animated view of the coronal holes in the southern hemisphere using solon.info, and we see two distinct features on the solar corona. The first of the features may be indicative of a high-speed solar wind stream affecting the Earth in around 24 to 36 hours, so we may see stepping up in solar wind speeds during that time frame. The second of these coronal holes, I will be making an earthquake watch, as I do feel there may be one or two significant earthquakes embedded in this coronal hole, so keep an eye on that video. We're now looking at the Stonyhurst heliographic, and taking a sneak peek of these active regions and coronal holes I'll be turning the limb for the coming week. Now, the main center of focus are 3 large active regions. The first is just about turning the limb, and it should be completely over in around 24 hours' time. It's still yet to be unnumbered, but this region is already producing C-class flares, and this promises to be producing some large M-class events in this coming week. Now, we do have 2 larger regions coming in the northern hemisphere, and they'll be fully over the limb or rotating over the limb in around 3 to 4 days' time, and these are also worth keeping a close eye on. And that's my solar watch for the 29th of November, 2011. For more information, please visit my website at solarwatcher.net. And I'm also working in conjunction with EQ Reporter, so please subscribe to that channel. Thanks for watching.